Hey, what's up, you guys? So in this video, I'm going to share with you how to manage your paycheck inside of Google Sheets. This works if you get paid weekly, bi-weekly, or monthly. All the numbers are customizable, and if you want a copy of the spreadsheet, I left the link in my bio so you can follow along. Okay, so inside of Google Sheets, the first thing we're going to do is underneath the month in your selector, you're going to choose the current month. So right now it's September, so I'm going to choose September and then choose the current year, which is 2025. You'll notice after I select the month and the year, the dates will auto-populate underneath daily spending. That's because of this formula. If you double tap into this right here, it's an array formula and it will automatically create all the dates for the month that you select. So for example, if I choose October, the sheet will update to all the days in October. Okay, so let's switch back to September. Now, next to income, you're going to choose your paycheck frequency. So here we have weekly, bi-weekly, and monthly. So for this example, I'm going to use bi-weekly. After I choose bi-weekly, you'll notice that two paychecks show up. And that is because of this formula. You can double tap it to check out how it works. And next to each paycheck, you're going to list how much you get paid for each bi-weekly paycheck. So let's say for example purposes that you get paid $2,000 per paycheck. Okay, so your total income here is $4,000 per month. And the next section we're gonna fill out is the bill section. So bills are gonna be mostly fixed expenses, larger expenses that you want to track before we get to this daily spending section. So let's list some example bills here, like rent, electric, internet, phone, car loan, gym, and let's say credit card. So these are just some examples. Obviously, you'll list in your own bills here underneath this section. Then after you fill in the bills that you want to track, you enter the amounts. So let's say rent is $2,000 per month. Electric is $200. Internet is $50. Phone is $100. Car loan is $350. Gym is $50. And your credit card payment every single month is, let's say, $250. Okay. So if you notice, as I entered in these amounts, this total expenses section started adding up. And so far, our total income is $4,000, total expenses is $3,000, which leaves us $1,000 left to budget. Okay, so this is a bill tracker. Every single time that you pay off these bills, you can mark them as paid. So let's say that we pay off rent to the landlord, we can mark this as paid. We pay off electric, we can mark this as paid. This is completely optional, but I think it's really helpful if you want to keep track of important bills that you don't want to miss. Okay, so after the bill section, I created a savings section as well. So for this section, you want to automatically set aside money towards savings before you start spending the rest of your money, the rest of your money being your left of budget. So let's say we have a monthly savings goal of setting aside $250 towards an emergency fund. So I'm gonna enter that here, emergency fund. And we set aside $250 per paycheck towards an emergency fund. That decreases our left of budget by $250. So we have $750 left for the month. And let's say also we want to save $250 every single month towards a vacation. For a future trip that we have coming up, we want to set aside some money towards that. Let's say it's $250 again. So our left of budget now is $500. So after our income of $4,000, which is listed here, our total expenses of $3,000, which is listed underneath bills, and setting aside money towards monthly savings, $500, we have $500 left to budget for the rest of the month. And this $500 is basically an allowance that we can use towards daily spending, groceries, having lunch with friends, going out for drinks, going out on a date, whatever you do to spend your extra money on. And so we're going to track that spending underneath daily spending. And so here, I'm just going to list some examples. So let's say that you go to McDonald's and you spend $50 there. And so you'll notice our laughter budget went down by 50 for that day. Let's say that the next day you go out and you buy some groceries and you spend money on gas. You'll notice I have two entries here. So you spent money on two things. So the next amount, you can press the equal sign. How much you spent on groceries. Let's say you spent $80 on groceries plus, let's say $50 on gas. So that total is $130 for the 2nd of September. That's how you do multiple spending amounts for the day. Let's fill in this table some more. So let's say we go to Walmart and spend $50. We have lunch. We have lunch with friends. And let's say that is $30. And then we have a dinner date and we spend $80. Okay, so our leftover budget now is $160. So you want to be careful with this number not to overspend. So for example, if you go shopping on this day and you spend $300, your leftover budget will turn negative. So this is what we want to avoid, is you want to make sure that after your bills are paid, after you're set aside for savings, you don't overspend the rest of your money for the month. Because if that happens, then you're tapping into debt or you're going to have to reduce your savings goals for the month. So you always want to make sure this number stays positive. So you basically repeat this process throughout the rest of the month. And then on the last day, the 30th, you're going to enter any spending that you had that day. So let's just say groceries again, and you spent 30. So obviously here, you're going to fill in your own spending for each month. And then your goal is to have a leftover budget above zero. So in this example, we have 110 left for our budget for the month. Obviously, I skipped a lot of days just to save time, but for yours, you're going to want to fill out this entire table. You can fill out the daily spending section every single day if you're that type, or you can fill it out once a week. So basically, you'll fill out 1 through 7 and then days 8 through 14. And you just do that 4 times a month that way. Okay, so let's say that you finish the month and you want to now proceed to the next month. So there's two ways you can do this. You can either save this progress and just duplicate the sheet. So you can go down to sheet 1, right click and click duplicate. You can rename sheet 1 as September of 2025. And rename this one to be the next month of October 2025. And then what you're gonna do is just delete the amounts, uncheck the paid, delete the savings, delete the daily spending, and then change the month here from September to October. And then you'll notice we now have the dates for October. So that's option number one. Option number two is you can just keep one tab and just delete the same things, all the data for the month. To refresh. And then change the month to October here. And then you just start over again for October and repeat the process. That's pretty much it for this spreadsheet. Again, your goal is to end every single month with a leftover budget above zero, after accounting for bills and after saving money towards your goals. So again, I left the link to the spreadsheet in the link in my bio. If you want to create the spreadsheet yourself, I made a full tutorial on how to do that. I'll leave the picture of the thumbnail right here so you know where to find it. Hopefully this was helpful for you. It's a very simple way to set up your finances in Google Sheets. If you have a different way of managing your paycheck, I'd love to hear it down in the comments below. Or if you have any questions, you can ask them and I'll do my best to reply to them. That's it for this tutorial and I'll see you in the next one.